Before you answer questions about all that you've learned so far, I want you to hear from Scott and Cole again. They're going to share some amazing resources so that you can create great data visualizations.
What tools or resources would you recommend that students use?
There are things like D3, right? There are like JavaScript libraries and these tools that are built to help you build totally customized visualizations. So that's sort of like on the advanced end. On the other hand, you have tools that are a little more like create kind of pre-canned visualizations, like Chart Wizard built into Microsoft Excel, or also like OpenOffice or LibreOffice, like these other sort of office type programs, which are really great, or Apple's Numbers does similar things. Tableau, I think, is a fantastic tool for starting out, and they just came out with a Mac version, which is great, as it opens up to a lot of us who use Macs. And Tableau, I don't want to say it makes like, they're not like canned visualizations, but it lets you just like really fast drop a data set on there and give yourself like a number of visual representations of that data. So you're like, oh, show me this as a bar chart, show it to me as a area chart, line chart, whatever. Or if there's geographic data, like show me this data on a map, like in a really fast way. So that's an awesome sort of like exploratory tool. And on the technical side, you know, there's like the other end of the spectrum from D3. Now, in between, there's a lot of stuff in between, like other chart libraries or online tools. The tools I think I'm excited about right now are sort of in this in-between place where they let you sort of dump your data in and generate some sort of visualization, but it's not trying to be the final visualization, and then you export that, bring it into some other tool, and start adjusting it. So for example, there's a tool out of the Density Design Lab in Italy called RAW, that's capital R-A-W. Mm-hmm. And you put some, basically drop your data on it, and it figures out sort of this is a representation I think will work. But it doesn't give you, and it's all like in one page, it's kind of like 1, 2, 3, you just go down this list and then you get like a graphic of some sort. And then you take that graphic and you export it and maybe bring it into Illustrator or some other program. Where you can do kind of the manual steps. So then you can say, oh, okay, well, now I set my fills and strokes and reposition things. I think that's like really nice and really powerful because it doesn't involve any coding. It doesn't involve a steep learning curve. And it also doesn't burden you with an interface that gives you a million like options for customization. Mm-hmm. It's just saying, I'm just going to get you started and like get you past that initial push so you get this one graphic, and then you can take it and tweak it. So there's a lot of exciting stuff like that, I think, that you could use.
So what tools or resources would you recommend for students who are getting started, be it maybe it's a blog or a particular software tool that you use?
Sure. So when it comes to tools, I think my number one piece of advice is try not to let your tool be a limiting factor. Right? Take the tool that you know and get to know it as well as you can. Most tools can be bent to meet your needs. And you can add more tools to your repertoire over time, but the knowledge of fancy tools need not be a barrier for entry in this space. I, for example, do almost all of my work in Excel because it's still the most pervasive for business communications, which is where I spend the majority of my time. When it comes to other resources out there, there is a wealth of information in the blogosphere and a lot of really great content. One word of advice is, you know, there's a lot of not great content as well. So be a discerning purveyor of data visualizations, right? When you come across a graph in a newspaper or in a blog, study it and note what you like and what you don't like and work to emulate those things that you see in other people's work that works well and avoid the bad. When it comes to some specific blogs that I'd recommend, and again, there are a whole lot of good ones out there, but I'll go through just a couple of my favorites today. First off is The Functional Art. So this is done by Alberto Cairo. He has a book of the same name that we talked about briefly. Next is Visualizing Data, which Andy Kirk runs. Flowing Data is Nathan Yao's blog, and he curates a lot of stuff that other people do, and yeah, another good example. And then I'd be remiss not to mention my own blog at Storytelling with Data. And actually, one more resource while we're flipping through pages here is John Schwabisch's Help Me Viz. So we talked earlier about seeking feedback. This is a place where you can actually submit data visualizations and get feedback from the community, and has been growing and has some really good good content, also as you're interested in just looking for data visualizations and examples of good stuff and bad stuff. It's a nice place to flip through.
Wonderful.